All right. Hello, Back to the Bench fans, and welcome again to another interview with UB and I. Hope everybody's staying safe right now. And today we actually got a bit of a different guest. It's not a player or a former player, but he's actually the former Collingwood Cheer Squad leader. It's Jeff Joffa-Korf. Thanks for your time, Joffa. How you been?
Greetings from Fiji, guys. Look, I've been well, but I want to come home. But like everyone else, you know, we've all been affected by this terrible global pandemic, and I'm stuck here in Fiji. So, yeah, greetings.
So you said Fiji. So I'm assuming you lived in Australia most of your life. Why did you move to Fiji?
Yeah. I just wanted a different direction in life. I just wanted to have a break. I was 20 years with the Salvation Army, looking after the homeless people and people with drug and alcohol problems and people with mental health problems as well. So look, I just thought that, you know, every day was beginning to be the same, and I was just getting tired, and I was grossly overweight. I've lost 33 kilos since I've been here in Fiji. Wow. I was mentally very tired, and I just thought I needed a change of direction in life. So I made a plan to come to Fiji for 3 months, have a bit of a break here, go back to Woz and come back here. And every 3 months I plan to alternate between Australia and Fiji. So I'm happy with it so far, but 8 months here in the jungle, boys, and I've got to get out. There's a fight in November, fingers crossed.
And you do work with children as well? You're doing some sort of thing there?
Yeah, well, in the cheer squad these days, you've got to have a working with children check, which clears you to work with kids. Yeah, so I've done all that sort of stuff, yeah.
That's great, Joffa. So, Joffa, you're probably one of the most iconic Collingwood cheer squad members of all time, especially with that golden jacket. Now, my question to you is, how did that jacket come about? What's the story behind it? Can you tell us about it?
That's a great question. I wore a gold wig. We wanted to do something different in the cheer squad. We'd had a long time of doing no good. We won a wooden spoon. It was nobody's fault. It was just the way things were back then. We'd won wooden spoons, and yeah, clubs were killing us every week. I think at one stage we'd lost 11 games straight. Eddie went over to Perth, got Mick Malthouse, and we could see a speck of light at the end of the tunnel with the signing of Mick. Eddie got me into the cheer squad. There's another big story there. And I thought that in the last quarter, let's do something different, celebrate victory. We had a gold wig, a gold tinsel wig. We used to put that on when the Pies were home. For the first few years under Mick, I think from memory, we struggled a bit. But then we started to win our fair share of games, and people started to take notice of this bloke and the cheer squad wearing a gold wig. And, well, one thing led to another. I was watching the footy show one night. Eddie McGuire had a gold jacket on. I was friends with Eddie back then, and still friends. I think I called him or emailed him, I can't remember. And I said, Ed, we've got to have that gold jacket. That would go with the gold wig when we celebrate victory in the last quarter. And Eddie loved it. And we met up at Victoria Park. We were still training at Victoria Park back then. He had to he knocked the jacket off from the Channel 9 wardrobe, boys. I think Bert Newton once wore it. Tommy Hemlin Jr. A lot of famous people at Channel 9 wore his gold jacket. And we met at Victoria Park. He gave me the jacket. He had a dry clean. And the rest has become, it was a big story, the gold jacket at Collingwood. The original gold jacket that he gave me is now framed and hanging up at the Holden Centre. I think it's still called the Holden Centre. Apologies for the new spot. The Holden Centre. It's framed and hanging up at the Holden Centre. Each year we get a new jacket. We auction the old jacket off every year. 1 year, the 2010 Premiership gold jacket we auctioned, and we got just under $5,000 for it for the Epilepsy Foundation. And each year we choose a different charity and auction the gold jacket for that charity, and then the following year we get a new one.
Cool. And how exactly did you get the cheer squad? So you got a message from Eddie. How did that all pan out?
Oh yeah, well back pre-2001 there was things weren't going too well at Collingwood. The club wasn't winning games. The there was factions in the outer. We had different cheer squads. We had the unofficial cheer squad. We had the official cheer squad. We had another squad. And Eddie got in and brought us all together. And I got a phone call from him, and the phone call was very direct and very frank. Be at Victoria Park on Thursday night at 7:30. We've got to sort this out. So we went to the meeting at the club, and all the factional squads, the cheer squads, came together, and we formed the new look Collingwood cheer squad, which was massive.
So Joffa, what is your best memories as a Collingwood fan in the cheer squad? What are your best memories over the years?
Oh, gee, I think when I get asked this question, I go back to the old football park in Adelaide, and Shane Kerrison had tackled Burgoyne in the goal square. It was a final.
And, Peter or Sean? Collingwood won that.
Sorry?
Which Burgoyne?
Oh, the Burgoyne that went to Hawthorn was playing for Adelaide then.
Sure.
Port Adelaide. In the dying minutes of the game, I'm pretty sure it was Shane Kerrison that brought Burgoyne to the ground, dropping the ball. And Collingwood went on to win that particular final. But what the biggest memory from that game was not only that particular passage of play in the dying minutes, but the celebration outside football park. I mean, I've been in a lot of celebrations with Collingwood supporters. Yeah, a premiership celebration and big match celebrations outside the MCG. But this particular night at football park, it just went off. It was just amazing.
There you
so
go.
That's over the 2010 grand final win.
No, this was way before then. This was, I can't remember what year. Collingwood people listening to this will remember it straight away. But it was, no, it wasn't Kerrison. Kerrison wasn't playing then. It was, gee whiz, guys. Burgoyne got tackled near the goal square in the dying minutes of the game.
We'll find it.
Sorry?
We'll find the footage.
Yeah. I just forget the player now who did it. But it won us the game, and it either got us into a grand final or we progressed to a preliminary final. I just can't remember. But the celebrations afterwards was just, I have never experienced anything like it. It was just amazing.
And that's what it's all about. It's all about celebrations. Yeah. There you go.
Oh, yes. I mean, I think, guys, if you talk about supporters celebrating victory, some of the winner's circles that we had outside Gate 1 at the MCG after a big win, thousands of Collingwood supporters would congregate together in a massive circle, and we would sing and chant, and just 97-year-old Collingwood supporters would be there, kids on mum and dad's shoulders. It was frantic, it was chaotic, it was passion. It was just some of the best memories were in that celebration circle outside Gate 1. And the Collingwood supporters watching this cast now, who will watch this interview, will share the same opinion as what I've just expressed. It was just, we do things differently at Collingwood, and and I think that's why people don't like us too much, because we do a bit differently.
That's a great memory, Joffa. Thanks for sharing that.
So we speak about best memories, Joffa, but what about the worst memories? Can you, locate them? Where did they happen?
Oh, there's nothing worse. And I'm not just talking on being a Collingwood supporter, but there's nothing worse when you're a supporter at a grand final and halfway during the last quarter, for whatever reason, you just know you're not going to get up. I mean, it's just so, so disappointing. I mean, you're happy you got there, but Collingwood supporters, we get there. But when we get there, we don't always win this bloody thing. 2011 was devastating because, for a Collingwood team to go back-to-back would be massive. And
your best team all year.
Well, in 92, Lee Matthews said that was the 92 side was better than the 90-90 side. And we, the structure of the final flows back then and stuff to start. So I think being in a grand final in the last quarter And you know you're not going to win. It's just so disappointing and heartbreaking.
Oh, it would be, yeah.
So which game is this one specifically?
2011 against Geelong.
Yeah. Was 2018 the same as you?
We won it in 2010. We were the best side in 2010. And we had our chances in 2011, but we just blew it. You know, it was another disappointing grand final for us.
Not ours' last game for the Pies, wasn't it? Yeah.
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 Yeah. All right, so Joffa, I'll take you back to 2018, that grand final. The Pies were up in the first quarter. I think they kicked the first 5 goals of the game. How were you feeling in that moment in the first quarter? You know, the goalie was on fire. Stevenson was killing it. That first quarter of that grand final, Pies were on fire. How were you feeling in that moment, and how did you feel when Dom Sheed kicked that goal to put him in front in the fourth to ice the game for him?
Well, it was against West Coast. Well, you know, it's just heartbreaking just going back to that memory of Dom Sheed kicking that goal. My belief is that we should have won that grand final. Things went against us in the last 3-4 minutes. The block on Maynard was paid a block all year, but funnily enough, on grand final day against Collingwood, it wasn't paid. Maynard said it was the block. It was certainly a block. We had other things in the last few minutes that didn't go our way, and we lost it. So, you know, what can you do? I mean, it's just so disappointing and heartbreaking. But it's disappointing and heartbreaking, but not just at that time, because it lasts forever. You know,
we'll always look back on it. It was so close.
Yeah, and we'll always look back on that, you know, for as long as we live. And we'll say, yeah, we were ripped off on that day. It was a grand final. It should have been a premiership for us. But again, you know, Collingwood, we're on grand final day. Things go against us like they always do, and we lost. You know, that's the disappointing thing. I think the frustrating thing about being a Collingwood supporter is we sit back, you know, over the last decade and a half or 2 decades, and we've seen Brisbane have a wonderful premiership era. We've seen Hawthorne have a wonderful premiership era, and Richmond are having one now. And we just can't seem to do that. And I think that's frustrating because, you know, my belief is a big club like Collingwood should be, we should have one of those wonderful premiership eras, but we just don't. And it's just so disappointing.
So what were you thinking when Dommy Sheed was lining up for that goal? Did you think he'd kick it? It was a hard shot.
Just under. Sheed from the boundary.
I said, fuck you. I said, fuck you, Sheed.
Yeah. I mean, you can
beat that out, guys. But look, I was sitting next to a mate of mine in the cheer squad, and we had 5 minutes to go, and I just couldn't believe the position we were in. And I remember saying to him, watch this turn to shit. We've been here so many times. We've been in this position so many times before of potentially winning a premiership, and it just goes against us. And when Sheed kicked that goal, I just thought, here we go. This is going to be another one.
Collingwood did play a pretty good game in that grand final. I still find it hard to believe you guys lost that grand final considering how well you did play. When the goalie did kick that goal, I think it was in the third or fourth quarter from 50 metres out. I think fourth quarter put you guys ahead a bit more, I believe. Is that when you thought, oh, probably this is ours now, you know, we've got the momentum, the goalie's kicked one from 50, let's go, boys? Or
No, when you're a Collingwood supporter, mate, and you've been to the grand final so many times, you never celebrate a premiership until it's a premiership because... like I said, you know, things go against us.
And we speak about horrible. We speak about losses in grand finals, Joffa, but another weird occasion that happened was, of course, that famous 2010 grand final against the Saints. Now, of course, you didn't lose the first final, but can you almost describe the feeling of what it was like to witness that siren when the scores were tied and the crowd were just dead silent? It was eerie.
Can you
put a word on it, Joffa?
What, on the draw or the premiership?
The draw one. First the draw, because that doesn't happen often, the draw.
Oh, God. When Goddard took that mark, because that was down my end, both of these incidents were down my end. Hmm. When Goddard took that sensational mark on grand final day, I thought, gee, this is a sign that St Kilda are going to get up. It was a fantastic mark. It was a brilliant mark by Goddard. And he kicked the goal. I thought, gee, this doesn't look good. Because it inspired the team. Milne and that bounce. If that bounce had gone into Milne's hands, we would have lost. Mm. I'm telling you now, we would have lost. But I'm not going to go into all that about Milne. We all know about Milne and his past. It wasn't meant to be for Milne. And we were lucky to get away with that draw. We were so lucky. I mean, that could have been another Collingwood heartbreak story right there. Don't forget, in that draw in grand final, that was the only third quarter all year that Collingwood didn't kick a goal. And it's grand final day. So what does that tell you? Mm-hmm. So, we're lucky to get away with that. But look, let's not dwell on that, because it was a draw and we moved on to a grand final replay. We showed the following week in that replay that we were the best side all year and we demolished them. So it was a fantastic effort that year by Collingwood. It was a wonderful premiership.
Yeah. Going by what you're saying, Joffa, with Collingwood and grand finals, throughout their existence, they've been in 40-odd grand finals and they've only won 15 of them. And they actually, can you walk us through that term, collie wobbles? How'd that come about?
Oh, guys, I'm going to jump off a bridge after this interview. Luke Richards coined the phrase collie wobbles long, long time ago, and that was simply because we were the best side all year, and whatever year we're talking about, that we made the grand final, we performed well in finals games, and we get to a grand final and lose. So the wobbles came about. You know, Collingwood are wobbling again. Look at them, they've wobbled, they've got into a grand final, and they've wobbled to defeat and lost another premiership. But after 1990, the wobbles were buried at Victoria Park. I was there that day. And we thought, good, the wobbles have gone. But they came back in 2002, 2003, 2011. And I'm not going to say we wobbled in 2018, because I think there was things went against us on that day that had nothing to do with the collie wobbles. But look, I don't care. You know, people love to hang shit on Collingwood and chokers and collie wobbles. But, you know, we don't care too much for names of Collingwood. We back for a wonderful club, led by wonderful people. We have a wonderful history. Hey, there's a lot of supporters out there that would wish that their club is very similar to Collingwood.
Yeah. Now, before we go, Joffa, we've got one last question for you. It's a bit of a different one, but...
Yep.
So I want you to close your eyes and set the scene here. I want to set the scene for you right now. So imagine it's a beautiful Saturday afternoon game at the G. It's a Carlton versus Essendon, Carlton Collingwood, Carlton Richmond, either or. 90,000 fans packed at the MCG. Great day for footy. And let's just say in the fourth quarter, it's close. And let's just say an opposition player, a Carlton player or an Essendon player, they kick a goal from the goal square running in. And after doing so, they absolutely go up to the Collingwood cheer squad and absolutely give it to you guys, rub it in your faces, maybe sticks the bird up. Now, Joffa, this is an uncensored podcast. Yes. You can say what you like. Go all out if you like.
Yes.
What is something you would say or do to that player?
What's your response?
Well, I'd say, okay, fuck yourself.
Yeah. I'm sure there's worse things said, but you know what I'm
saying?
Face to face.
I would say, go, and I'll say it again, go fuck yourself.
How many times per game do you reckon you've done that one?
Oh, mate, I tell you what's embarrassing, guys. Football's a passionate game, and you say things at the football that you don't mean to. Well, later on in years, I had to appreciate that people can lip read. So I had to try and be very careful what I actually said in the heat of the moment, because people can lip read the word C, and they can lip read the word F, and it's not a good look for me, because I you know, I mean, I've you've just been. I just had to be careful how I behaved, and I think that became unenjoyable because I used to love being me and letting it rip.
Yeah.
But then, you know what I mean? But then you had to sort of be mindful of the kids at home were watching this on TV, and there's Jopper saying the C word and the F word, and I was very mindful of that. You know, I had to be very careful.
Because you're such an iconic Collingwood Cheer Squad member. Everyone knew you, the fans.
Well, I don't know if it's the word iconic, guys. I just... I wore my heart on my gold jacket, and I loved the Pies like all Collingwood supporters do. And it's a big story. My involvement with Collingwood, I don't run the club. I'm nothing. I'm just a supporter. But it's a wonderful story. And the day when I go depart this earth, people look back, see this guy in the gold jacket, and they'll ask, "Gee, who was this like?" And that feels good. Yeah, you know, I've left my mark at Collingwood, I think it's fair to say, without sounding too egotistical. Eddie McGuire has been great, and I've had a wonderful time at Collingwood, guys.
Cool. Well, thanks so much for joining the show, Joffa. I really appreciate you, spending your time with us. Best of luck for the future, and hope you're enjoying that Fijian sun, if there's any there right now.
Well, it'll come, but it's just a little bit behind the clouds at the moment. But I'll be back in those. I'll be maybe some games next year. I'm not sure what I'm doing, but hopefully I'll be back in those before Christmas to see the family and a civilised lifestyle.
And before you go, quick tip before the final.
Okay, well, the Pies are still there, guys, so I've got to say Collingwood. If not Collingwood, I'll say Richmond.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you very much, Jopper.
Take care.
Thanks.
Bye there. That's Fiji. Bye. Bye there, Vanaka.
Thank you.